This is Calvin Kastein. We're at Beekmantown Central School. It's Saturday afternoon, November 7th, 1998. And we are here in a gym that hopefully will be even a little more crowded than it is now for the Section 7 Gymnastics competition, featuring the six schools from throughout the CVAC area. And they'll all be here in one crowded little gymnasium known as Beekmantown. The schools competing today, see if we can remember them without looking at our list, will be Au Sable Valley, Beekmantown, Peru Central, Plattsburgh, Seton Catholic, and Ticonderoga. Total of six. We'll be concentrating on the floor routine. There'll be all four events will be happening at the same time. On the far end, or you usually come in if you attend a basketball, volleyball, wrestling match here, or even gymnastics usually coming through there, but they have the vault set up there. That's the normal entrance. So now today people are walking down the hall and coming in on the side down here. So the vault is at the far end. The floor routine is here. Right in front of us is the balance beam, and on the far side is the uneven bars. We'll be glancing at those events when nothing is happening on the floor. But the only competitors we'll be keeping track of will be the ones on the floor, because just a one-man show here would be impossible to try to know who was up at a given time when we're not following it. So if you're interested in the gymnastics, particularly the floor routine, we hope you'll stick around. And again, we'll try to get as much of the other stuff as we can, probably very little of the vault, because I'm sure most of the time we'll have somebody here on the beam or on the uneven bars and nobody's on the floor. So hope you'll stick around and enjoy Section 7 Championship Gymnastics on Hometown Cable. I believe is Au Sable Valley. They're coming out alphabetically. This would be Beekmantown, Peru, Plattsburgh High School, Seton Catholic, and Ticonderoga. And the judges.
Junior Captain Teresa Riddle, for the Peru Central School Indians, coached by Kevin Lemoy and Jonathan Starr. The Indian senior captains are Alicia Alger and Katie Everett. The Blacksburg High School Hornets, coaches Janice Trudeau and Natalie Schaefer. Senior captain, Hannah Franz. And junior captain, Rachel Luck. Seton Catholic Central School Knights, coached by Chrissy Francis. Senior Brett Studley, captain. And senior Marilee Bernard. For the Ticonderoga Central School Sentinels, coached by Dee Hughes. Senior captain Michelle DeFranco. And senior Mindy Bergie. Our judges would like to recognize them this afternoon. On ball, Terry Phelps and Maureen Austin. On bar, Gail McCann and Penn Newton. On the balance beam, Julie Haddad and Vera Haskell. On floor, Laura Windsor-Irwin and Andy Snyder. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we ask you to rise for our national anthem sung by three members of the VII Gymnastics Central School Gymnastics team, Katie Marr, Tracy Fountain, and Teresa Riddle.
Job indeed by the three Beekman Town performers.
There will be a three-minute touch before the first rotation. The first rotation is as follows. Seton will be on ball. Blacksburg on bars. ABC, Osable is out. That's Peru on bars. Blacksburg on B. Beekman Town on floor. Have a good
meeting,
everyone.
And I want to point out Mark Donnelly, the athletic trainer or whatever he is. Not sure what his title is, but he's here making sure any injury will be taken out, taken care of.
Please, no flash cameras, no flash photography.
Athletic trainer Mark Donnelly and Steve Broadwell, the athletic director.
Here is you, please. We're praying for that. That would be great.
Ah!
The home team, the Big Eagles, will be up on the floor first. We have somebody going up on the beam, so we'll look there until we get ready to go to the floor. This is probably an exhibition. I don't think this is one of the competitors. She's testing out the beam, I guess. Testing out the bars over there. So we have two youngsters here. Didn't notice her over on the bars. Again, this is not a contestant, this is an exhibition only. But since it's happening, we'll tape it. And we've got the other one on the vaults over there. All these two girls are going through their routines for the folks. Set for the first event, I believe. The games are underway at 4 o'clock start, 4:38, so a little behind. Oops. Somebody on the uneven bars, somebody on the balance beam, so we'll see if we can get them both in the same picture while we're waiting for the floor routine to start. It's Peru, I believe, on the uneven bars, and Plattsburgh on the beam. Numbers that they're holding up for the fans' sake, given the scores. Looks like we have our first competitor on the floor for Beekmantown. It should be Michelle Kelly for Beekmantown. Thank you. Bill Kelly from Beacon Town Central. I think we have a vaulter coming. Teresa Riddle is due next on the floor for Beacontown. Teresa Riddle. Again, we'll glance at the other competitors, but there's nobody on the floor. Our concentration, we'll mention this several times today, will be on the floor. Teresa Riddle. Not done when the music stops, we better be done. Teresa Riddle. Tracy Fountain will be next for Beacontown. Tracy Fountain next for Beacontown. Thank you. Here comes the Riddler. Katie Marr will be next for Beacontown on the floor. Almost didn't see her in the crowd over there, Kaylin Fassett. If you back up, there's just another face in the crowd, but there she is, and she's up next. Let me see if my sheet says what grade she's in. We know she's not a senior. She's a seventh Gerader. What was your seventh grader doing this afternoon? Stacey Banholtz will be the last one on the floor for Hickman Town. She had her own little cheering section back here. Ben Holt. Looks like she's pleased with her performance. I think we have a competitor up here. It looks like the judges are concentrating on her efforts. We have somebody on the floor. Plattsburgh is will be on the floor next. And it's Erin Durham. She's a junior. Seems like nobody smiles when they come off the balance beam. It occurred to us that we could have given you the grade level of all the participants that we've done so far. So we're going to back up on Beacontown and tell you the grades that the competitors are in. Michelle Kelly is a 10th grader, Teresa Riddle, 11th grader, Tracy Fountain, a senior, Katie Marr, 11th grade, Kaylin Fassett, as we said, a 7th grader, and Stacy Banholt is a sophomore. So I'll be giving you that from here on in. Next up is Miriam Rubin for Plattsburgh. She's a freshman. Rubens on the floor. Amber Carnahan is next for Plattsburgh on the floor. Amber Carnahan, freshman. Thank you. Amber Cunningham. Up next for Plattsburgh on the floor will be Megan Hecox, and she's also a freshman. So she'll be next on the floor for Plattsburgh. Glad we got to see that one. Nice job. I believe that's Seton Catholic. And now we're set. Freshman Megan Hecox. Hear the warning, and I don't think anybody heard the warning, but must have been kind of low and quiet. She didn't hear the warning, and it can be a little upsetting, I imagine. All of a sudden, you hear time, these events on the balance beam are timed. Let's see, Hannah France will be next for Plattsburgh. And she's a senior. Hannah France. Thank you. Fonks, senior from Plattsburgh. But getting back to the beam, not sure how long before time is called that they give the warning, but they do get a warning, and then a few seconds later they say time. So when you don't hear the warning, and all of a sudden you hear time, it can be a little disconcerting, because instead of having a chance to finish up what you need to do, all of a sudden you're done without warning. So if you don't hear that warning, I'm sure, and there's a lot of noises in the gym with people shouting for their favorite performer with four venues, plus the music from the floor routine. This should be junior Rachel Luck. Be the last one on the floor for Plattsburgh. Rachel Luck. Sable Valley on the floor, and Amanda Senecal, a freshman, will be up first. Thank you. Looking at a vulture coming. Here we go, Kristen Bombard, senior. Kristen Bombard, a senior, now Silver Valley. Jatha Minor, a senior. Jatha Minor, and our Sable Senior. don't know if you spotted her. She was going right over the top of that bar, swinging right around. And the fans certainly enjoyed it. Julie Bola will be next on the floor for our Sable. And she's there. Bola's a freshman. On the floor we have Molly Gardner. She's a senior. Senior Molly Gardner. Gardner from Sable Valley. She's a senior. All right, let's get two of them up there. Synchronized balance beam. Synchronized balance beam here on hometown table. Courtney White is the last one up for Alsable. I believe she's a senior. She is indeed. So Alsable has four seniors this year. At this level, at least competing at the on the floor. Full audience. Back to the synchronized event. On the floor in the background there, you might notice it's Mindy Conroy. She's a freshman for Peru. And she'll be the first one on the floor for Peru. And she stepped off the floor. And she's going home. Conroy is set, and so are we. and Megan Conroy. She looks disappointed. Looked good to me, but there's must be some things that she didn't do that she wanted to do. Also, a disappointment, I'm sure, when you get here to the big event and you're not quite satisfied with your performance. But like I said, looked fine to me. Chandler will be up next for Peru on the floor. She's a junior. Chandler, a junior, as we said. Chandler. Katie Everett, senior. Katie Everett. Next for Peru, Kelly O'Hara, a freshman. Kelly O'Hara, and she's a freshman. Thank you. Nicole Martin. On the floor for Peru. Should point out, while we're thinking of it, that no way are we getting most, I should say all, but we are getting most of the performers. The school's average probably about 10 competitors here, split up in the four events. So we're getting six per event, so we're getting most of them, but Seton Catholic has only five here, and we'll be getting all five of theirs, obviously. This girl here is an 8th grader, and her name is Kathleen Clowes. Alright, judges have kindly scored the preceding one, so now Kathleen Clowes on the floor, an 8th grader. Okay, we fell asleep that time, but we're on the ball now. Seton Catholic on the floor. This is eighth grader Rachel DeCamp on the floor. Seaton. Okay, 8th grader Rachel DeCamp is on the floor. Next for Seton will be Kendall Harford. Harford, a 7th grader, will be next for Seton Catholic. Seventh grader, Kendall Harford. Ticonderoga now on the beam here. They are the league champions this year in the CVAC. Narrowly defeating Beekmantown. Nobody's happy coming off the beam. Next for Seton, a senior, Brett Studley. Brett Studley next for Seton Catholic. There's Plattsburgh on the uneven bars. Whoops. Brett Studley. Oh, looks like they're going to fix the floor mat. Alright, now we have senior Brett Studley on the floor. Right. Brett Studley, senior. It's the whole team, all five of them over there. Next on the floor will be Marilee Bernard for Seton Catholic, and she is a senior. Do some synchronized beam while we're waiting here. Let's synchronize dismount. We're waiting for those judges right there. Looks like they're finally ready. So Marilee Bernard Sr. for Seton on the floor. Synchronized balance beam time. Stacy Frechette will be the final one on the floor for Seton Catholic. Okay. 3 for set. One seat in calf lock. Mindy Bergie on the floor for Ticonderoga. And she is a senior. Senior from Ticonderoga. And I'm not sure if she's happy with her performance or not. Jenna Porter, a freshman, is next for Ty. She decided not to vault, I guess. Looks like she has cut her hands. If it's not powdered up enough, I'm sure you get burns. It looks like she burnt her hands. Jenna Porter is on the floor. Freshman from Ticonderoga. As soon as the music starts, we'll be there. Thank you. Porter from Ticonderoga, freshman. Sophomore Nevada O'Connor is next for Ty. Nevada O'Connor. Mara Morehouse, who's an eighth grader, will be up next on the floor for Ticonderoga. Mara Morehouse. She's in a hurry for that music to start, I'll bet. Morehouse. And when Katie Marr got off the beam, looked like she was happy with her effort. Looks like the uneven bars are done. Heather McMurdy. We are next to the last performer on the floor. She is a seventh grader for Ticonderoga, Heather McMurdy. Unlike just about every other sport we can think of, but the gymnastics, there's one sectional winner. There's not B, C, and D type of efforts. Looking a little bit like Liz DeFranco is Michelle DeFranco. She'll be the last one on the floor, and she's, of course, from Ticonderoga. Now we have somebody on the beam. Michelle DeFranco on the floor. Thank you. Michelle DeFranco. And a quick look around indicates that that's going to be our last competitor. Now all we have to do is find out who won.
The Beekmantown Eagles were the winners with a total of 154.6, narrowly defeating Ticonderoga, finished at 153.5. In third place was Seton Catholic with 147.2, Peru at 142.4, Plattsburgh High School with 141.9, and Arcebo Valley with 137.6. Kayleen Fassette took the vault, followed by DeFranco, Frechette, Berge, Marr, and O'Connor. Frechette won the floor routine, followed by White, Luck, Fassette, Banholt, and Martin. On the bars, it was Fassette, Frechette, DeFranco, McMurty, Morehouse, and Luck. On the beam, it was Fassette, Marr, DeFranco, Banholt, Frechette, and Luck. All around, Fassette won it. She was followed by Frechette, DeFranco, White, Luck, and McMurty. So there you have it, the 1998 Section 7 champions, as seen here on Hometown Cable, the Beekmantown Eagles, led by their 7th grader, Kayleen Fassette.
For that tumbling, hop in the corner, join us, it would be great. Thank you.